if we were to look at a piece of quartz, you know, we generally will take and we'll slice and dice, we'll lap and polish down a piece of quartz. To make it functional, we put a couple electrodes across it. So now you have contacts in order to make connection to your electrical circuit. Well, if we apply a voltage, say a DC voltage, through this wonderful piezoelectric effect, you're going to change, you're going to make a physical change to that structure. It's going to move. How is it going to move? Well, that depends on how you built it. That depends on the mode you see at the bottom corner. And the cut of the crystal, where you place the electrodes, the spacing, all matter on how that crystal will move. Well, we're trying to store and release energy. Well, this is exactly what you've done here. When you create a change, a physical change, that crystal wants to simply return back to its original shape. It's not going to stay in that shape. And it does that very efficiently. You remove the voltage on those electrodes, the crystal will fall back into its normal shape that it was before. And vice versa, just as much as your barbecue grill or that cigarette lighter, you induce a physical change, you have to release the button. You release the button, and that's the clang. Out comes the voltage. This is the basic idea behind our oscillators. Take an amplifier. Put a piece of quartz in series with it. So now what happens is there's always noise within the system. Your regulators generate noise. There's just noise within transistors, any type of gates. And that noise is presented upon an amplifier. That amplifier increases its signal on the output. It's fed into the quartz. And now the quartz sees a signal. It sees a voltage potential. And that voltage potential, through the piezoelectric effect, you're catching on here, is now making a deformation to the blank. And that deformation is now wanting to release. Well, there's nothing holding it in that position. The losses of the circuit are allowing it to start to release and relax back to its normal position. That's the feedback mechanism. That's the release portion of the store and release energy. That releases energy back into the circuit, which feeds back now into the amplifier. As long as the gain of that amplifier is higher than all of the losses within the system and that efficiency of that quartz, it will continue to increase in amplitude until limited by the circuit. That's the fundamental building block behind our oscillators. Now, this is generally put together by saying we have an electrode, a piece of quartz, just as much as you did here, but we will deposit electrodes to the top and also to the bottom of that quartz. So you have an electrode on the top, you have an electrode in the bottom. These electrodes are epoxied to pins onto a header. They're glass fed through to the outside world, and then a cap is put on. It's either resistance weld or cold welded, and that seals the crystal inside the cavity. Now, you have a crystal lead here and here, and you also have a ground pin. You'll see that on many oscillator applications where you have two crystal pins. It's not a positive, negative, it's just two crystal leads. Well, a crystal is reversible. You can place it in any direction that you want. And those are these two points. And that's the crystal that goes into our oscillators. That's the basic building block behind our oscillators. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more, head over to microchip.com/mission assurance.